Welcome back to Let's Play the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in Horuku, which is there. I'm not sure. We have to go. Came from Oldos. Desert checkpoint. I guess we're going this way because we haven't been to any of this stuff. Folthia. Yeah. We're supposed to go to Folthia. Yeah, all the way to Castle Rudo. Quite a long journey. If no other travelers are on their way, all you have to do is make sure nobody leaves the town. The eastern entrance can be guarded by one soldier. Yeah, they don't want anyone be coming and going. Oh. Nope. We don't need that. Alright, so we'll look around. Monsies says, welcome. Jurio says, hello. Man, our king is causing problems, too. I hear that after listening to some traveler, he closed off all the borders. If travelers can't get in, we won't get any business. Jurio, let's get some rest here. No. We just did that. Anything else? Or anyone else here? No? Hello? Sia says, welcome to the tool shop. Feel free to look around. Alright, there's potions. Maybe we should buy a few of these Furuo potions. Safi Volume 8, that's a new one. That's all we want. Alright, let's take a look at the Safi book. I had an itch on my finger. Rematch. Renowned swordsmen from throughout the realms arrived to fight in front of King Topaz. Brad and Safi drew particular attention because everyone knew about their recent duel. Under the curious gazes of aristocrats looking for blood and glorious skills, Brad and Safi began a rematch. There would be no surrender. The title of first-class swordsman would be given to the winner, but the title had no value to Safi. Staring at Brad, she coordinated her breath, bring down the man in front of her, and her life as a swordswoman would end. Safi drew her well-used saber and dashed at the overwhelmed Brad like a gust. She thrust her saber twice at his head and once at the side in perfect rhythm. Initially on the defense, Brad turned to offense against Safi, whose attacks became somewhat monotonous. Safi repeated the same offensive pattern whenever she had a chance. Everyone knew who the winner was. Safi repeated the same movements like there was nothing else she could do. However, in the final move, she managed to twist her wrist and shoved her saber toward Brad's head. He knew it was coming, but Brad reacted in the same pattern his body had learned from Safi's repetitious movements. With her saber pressed against his forehead, Brad threw away his cutlass silently. A woman fighter became the number one swordsmaster in the country. Yay! I wonder if that's the last book. Seems like it could be. And so there's another room here. I can't believe you're traveling at such a young age. Good luck. Grab the arms dealer. Okay, so he's the type where if you stand across the table, then you can buy stuff. Hi, we have good weapons here. Take a look around. Sundering sword, nice. A massive, powerful sword, 4,000. Alright, let's do the exchange so we know how much money we're dealing with. It's a good amount of money. Alright, so that's gonna be a little more than half our money. Crystal Rod. Nobody needs that. Staff of Light, I think, is what we have currently. Large Shield, Jurio has. Bronze Armor. Yeah, it's a step down in some ways. Fleeting Robes is what we're all wearing, I think. Alright, so all we want is the Sundering Sword, then. That's good. You're welcome. Come back anytime. And we don't need to come back, because we bought the only thing that we need from you. So it's his attack goes from 176 to 197. That's gotta be noticeable. Alright, so let's sell the broadsword. Okay, good. It's in here. It's people. Lark says, Fenthi is divided into the north and the south. The north is ruled by King Enatan in Hazen. The south is ruled by King Calak at this mansion in Horuku. The two are twins. The queen separated the kingdom into two so that the brothers wouldn't fight. Yunio says, King Hazen and King Calak are both very timid people. However, there's no telling what King Calak will do when cornered. Make him sound like a rat or something. He can be very dangerous. Veld says, I wonder what King Calak is thinking. He's blocked off not only the south-north road, but all the other ones too. Looks like a stage. Oh. We're just, like, dancing around. That's pretty random. Hi. I said hi. Rukon says, I saw a strange traveler come out of the mansion. I think he headed north along the north-south road with some soldiers. Yeah, anything else to say about him? Okay, no mind. I didn't go in here, did I? Nope, we did come in here. I want to get some rest. No rest. Hello? Welcome to the chapel in Horuku, says Panya, the chapel master. You can stay as long as you like. Okay. If I go across to... Oh, they just sell pet food. Anything new? It's all the same stuff. Okay. We have enough pet food. We always have enough pet food. We need to increase our rabbit's, like, metabolism so we'll eat more often. So still not hungry. Oh, I got stuck over there. Oh, here we go. Ritika says, I haven't seen Queen Carrie lately. I wonder if she's inside the mansion. I really like her a lot. Sounds like you have a little something special for her. Oh, I'll talk to you last. Siorn says, a strange traveler came by not too long ago. He was handsome, but had very cold eyes. He went inside the king's mansion. After that, everything about Horuku became strange. Strange how, exactly. Let me guess, you sell pet food? Jan, the Canned Master, says be sure to only use spells to protect yourselves. Don't use them to harm forest animals in the forest. Forest animals in the forest. So what if we find forest animals that are not in the forest? Yeah, I don't want your pet food. Shuno says, I wonder what the king is thinking, blocking off the roads. I hope he's not thinking about going to war with the North. Sarna says, I think that the king is being manipulated by that strange traveler. I'm so worried. What's going to happen to Finthy? It will be utterly destroyed. And your bones will be found among the rubble. Wait, no, I didn't say that out loud. Who's that? Addy says, huh? The roads have been blocked off? I wonder if all three have been shut down. I heard that the north-south road was closed due to construction, but I guess they started construction elsewhere, too. No, I'm pretty sure it doesn't have anything to do with construction. Nice try, though. Looks like we can walk back there. I guess the mansion is through there. Oh, we didn't talk to that old lady, did we? Grandma Annie says, when the queen was still alive, King Calak and King Anaton got along. I just wish they would work together to rule Fenty instead of fighting each other. Oh, he's got notes for us. Maggio the Elder says, it's just like that little girl said. Chris says, what do you mean? Before, maybe about 20 years ago, oh, the Moonlight Witch? When the Moonlight Witch came here, she was saying something about this. Mother divides blood, not to divide the country. That's what the Moonlight Witch said. Huh. Sell pet food? No? This area is closed. The shores of Lake Rupinas are too muddy, so we're fixing the roads. Take some other route. No way. You can't get through until the construction is done. How rude. So that's where the three roads are. One, two... You! We have orders to block off the eastern border. You can't get through even if you get to the checkpoint. If you don't believe me, that's fine, but you still won't be able to get through. Alright, so it's one, two, and then the third is over here. And the mansion must be to the north then. Alright, so let's talk to him. I think... Did I go in here? I think I talked to her, right? Yeah. Making sure I didn't miss anybody. Stimulant, do not need. This road is closed. I can't let you out until the borders are reopened. Oh no, says Philly. Jurio and Chris won't be able to get back to Folthia. Jurio says, Philly, what about that rough road you were talking about? That's up ahead too. Chris says, you can't get back to your house either. It looks like none of us can get out of Horuku. Chris says, we should try to talk to someone important here. At the mansion. The road to Gedona is closed under orders from King Calak. Jurio says, huh? Why? Just explained it. Chris says, then we can't get back to Folthia. We can't let you through until King Calak's orders have been rescinded. Okay. Try for this mansion then. Did I visit everyone here? Calak Mansion. What do you want? This is King Calak's mansion. Normal folk can't just come in here. Chris says you sound so cold. Heh, I'm nice compared to the others. The soldiers at the entrance aren't as nice as I am. Oh, Peachy. If the soldiers at the entrance let you through, I'll do a handstand and spin around 3 times. Jurio says, is that a promise? Of course that's a promise. Looking around. Maybe there's a back way in. You got a peek in there. Okay, that's a stormtrooper and a tall Yoda. Maybe it's a Jar Jar Binks. Oh, nice. Look at the statues. I approve. Oh! Yay, a recure potion. Haha. Back to you again. Can't get in that way. Oh, see, we're full of full cure potions now. I can't talk to her. I have to come down to talk to her. So they won't let us in, but they'll let us run all the way around here. Someone back there. Hi. Man, all the soldiers here are so stubborn. But they're not bad people. Don't get mad at them, okay? I'll try. Let's try guard on the right. We can't let regular citizens through. Please go back the way you came. How about the one on the left? We can't let you through. Chris says, it's no use. They won't even talk to us. Philly says, weren't they saying near the border that they were good friends with the ambush? I don't think they'll let us through unless we're messengers from ambush or something. Oh, says Jurio. Chris says, what's wrong with Jurio? That's it. We have the ring that Alf gave us. Oh yeah, the ring. I'm sure we can use it to convince them that we're messengers from ambush. Philly says, who's Alf? Oh, Alf's the king of ambush. He's a really nice guy. Chris says, he's a little strange though. Jurio says he's easygoing, and he really cares about his people. Chris says he's got a bad sense of direction, just like someone else I know. He's strong and admirable. Chris says he likes to eat. I'm trying to say nice things about him. Philly says, you're friends with the king of ambush? Jurio, you must have great connections. But I don't think it's good to call a king by his first name. Yeah, I know it's bad, but I'm so used to it. Chris says, it doesn't matter now. Okay, so do we have a plan? Let's go, Jurio. Get the ring ready. Okay. Jurio made sure he still had the ring. Chris says, we're going to show it to the guards at the entrance and ask to see the king as messengers from ambush. Jurio says, but when we showed it when we were at Bolt, we got in trouble, remember? I wonder if it's going to be okay this time. We have no choice. We need to hurry and check up on Fothia. Okay, let's go. We can't let you through. Jurio says, we forgot to tell you something last time. Yeah, we forgot. We are messengers from ambush. Yes, we are. Oh, really? I suppose you have some proof? Mind if I take a look at it? Of course, says Chris. Jurio, let him see it. Okay. Jurio showed him the ring. This is the crest of ambush. Chris asks, well, how about it? It's the real thing, isn't it? Yeah, it looks like it's real. So, what? Says Chris. How did you get your hands on this? Huh? Says Jurio. You don't believe us? Says Chris. There's no way a bunch of kids can be messengers from Ambush. How dare you? We completed the initiation into adulthood by making our pilgrimage. We're adults now. Pilgrimage? That's strange. I thought you were a messenger from Ambush. The soldier looked at Jurio doubtfully. You're not a very nice guy, are you? Says Chris. You probably bought that Ambush ring from some black market. Philly says, that's pretty rude. Why are you wanting to see King Calak so badly? Something funny is going on here. I'm going to take you into custody and start an investigation. Chris says, you're kidding, right? Jurio says, I knew this was going to happen. Are they in jail now? Oh, they're being questioned. You guys are acting mighty suspiciously. First you say you're messengers, and now you tell me you're on a pilgrimage. Jurio says, we became friends with the King of Ambush while we were on our pilgrimage. Come on, let us see the King of Horuku. We need to talk to him. You'd better tell me the truth. We can tell right away whether you're really messengers from Ambush or not. This man, says Chris, is not listening to anything we say. I'm getting tired of this, Jurio. Me too. Well, let me ask a few questions. We'll start with you. The soldiers started questioning Chris. If you are messengers from Ambush, you should be able to answer these easily. What's the name of the head chef at Ambush? Oh boy. You mean Amdara? Yuruno, right? I believe that's it. Ugh, that's right. Next, the boy. The soldier turned to question Jurio. What's the name of the canned magician who is the king's advisor? Morrison, right? Don't just call him by his first name. Say Mr. or Sir. He's really powerful. Well, he answered your question. But he's our friend, says Jurio. You still say things like that? It's the truth. Chris says, I was right, wasn't I? Question 3. The soldiers started to ask Philly questions. Well, she's not going to know it. She joined us later on. Now it's your turn. Chris says, hey, Mr. Soldier. What? It's no use asking her questions about Ambush. She joined us after we left. Even more suspicious. From what country? Finthy. I live in a house near North-South Road. What's your name? Philly. Philly? I've heard that name before. Philly... Oh! You're Riz the apothecary's daughter, aren't you? Yes, I am. I went to your mom's place to get some medicine for my grandmother. That medicine really worked great. Thanks to that, my grandmother is still healthy as a horse. My, you've grown. Are horses considered especially healthy? So what brings you here today? Chris says he's behaving so differently now. Jurio says, I guess we're saved. These two are Jurio and Chris. They're on a pilgrimage, but the roads have been blocked off, and they can't get back home. We came here to ask the King of Horuku if he can let them through. Actually, I can't get home either. Oh, I see. Well, that's not good. The roads have been closed by direct order from King Calak. Jurio asks, why did he shut the roads down? I can't really tell you. Chris says, now you're acting suspiciously. I don't understand either, but the king's been behaving strangely since a traveler named Bellart came. Bellart? You guys said that your message is from Ambush, didn't you? You answered the questions right, and it doesn't seem like you're lying about being friends with Ambush. Maybe Ambush can help us solve King Calak's problems. Can you meet with King Calak and listen to his problems? Of course, says Chris. Sure. I'll go ask if King Calak will see you. Wait here, okay? Guess we don't have a choice. Chris says, I wonder what the King of Horuku is worried about. Jurio says, I hope we can help him out. Hey, kids! King Calak is asking to see you. King Calak is in this room. I'm counting on you. Greetings, Your Majesty, Jurio says. Oh, he has green hair. Are you the messengers from Ambush? We're really not messengers, but we know King Alf really well. I see. Well, I have a problem. A problem? Says Chris. Please come in. About a month ago, a traveler named Bellart visited me here. According to him, my older brother, the King of Hazen, is planning on expanding his territory by attacking Horuku. Philly says, there's no way that's true. Jurio and I came through the north, and there was no sign of that. That's what I think, too, but when I hear such rumors, I have to be concerned. After hearing what Bellart said, I started preparing for defense, in case we are indeed attacked. Jurio says, preparation? For war? No, nothing that major, but we started building a fortress on the shores of Lake Rapinas near the north-south road. I don't think it's a good idea to build a fortress. If you do that, a war will be fought even if you didn't plan on starting one. Chris says, why? Well, what if that guy named Bellart is telling lies? The King of Hazen will see that you're building a fortress along the road and wonder why. There's no way he wouldn't think that you're up to something. Chris says, I think the King of Hazen will prepare for war, too. Jurio says, then there will be a war, even if none of you are planning to start one. Philly says, I think you're right, Jurio. This could be very dangerous. Chris says, Your Majesty, this Bellart character seems to be someone you shouldn't trust. King says, I thought something might be wrong, so I halted the construction of the fortress, but Bellart has taken control. He fears I'm withdrawing my support, so he took the Queen as prisoner to the fortress to ensure the operation continues. The Queen? Philly says. Yes, Queen Carrie is being held prisoner in the fortress. If I order a stop to the construction, there's no telling what Bellart will do to the Queen. Chris says, one problem after another. Jurio says, first you have to let the King of Hazen know that you're not planning on fighting with Horuku. He is Horuku. From Horuku. Chris says, we also have to make sure that the King of Hazen isn't planning on attacking Horuku, even though I doubt he is. Of course, we have to rescue the Queen, too. Philly says, someone should find out what kind of a person Bellart is and what his history is. King Calak says, I have no intention on fighting against my older brother. Is there any way to get out of this predicament? Jurio says, if you do something obvious, Bellart may get suspicious. Then Her Majesty will be in danger. Chris says, man, that's not good. If we ask for Ambush for help, I think it'll just get even worse. So we'll go to North Finthy, Your Majesty. You will stay here. We'll go to Hazen and check out what's going on there. But now maybe something will be going on in the castle at Hazen. If they're preparing for war, we'll let them know what's going on and clear up any misunderstandings. That's a good idea, says Philly. I think King Eniton will believe us. King Calak, if you let us use the eastern road, we can use the rough road we use to gather herbs. We can get to Hazen without passing through the fortress at Lake Rapinas. Bellart will never know. I see. Very well. I'll order the soldiers at the gates to let you pass so that you can use the eastern road. I entrust you with the task of telling Eniton that I have no wish to fight him. I will put a stop to Bellart. We can rescue Queen Carrie once the situation with Hazen is clear. Jurio says, don't start a battle no matter what, okay? Do not concern yourselves, I will not start any battles. Let me write a letter to prove that you are an official messenger from Horuku. Please wait a moment. Give this to my older brother, King Eniton. He will understand once he reads it. Jurio and his party received Kalak's letter. The soldiers will not cause you any trouble in your journey. Soldier! Yes, Your Majesty? Make arrangements for these travelers so that they can get through to Hazen via the Eastern Road. Yes, Your Majesty. And there he goes. Okay, Your Majesty, says Jurio, we're going. I'm reluctant to send you on this dangerous mission, but I have no choice. Unless we can stop this, we'll end up waging war. Please give the official letter to my older brother so that he understands the situation. just says that again. Can we read this letter? Probably not. Calak's letter calling truce with his brother. Who are you? Opal, the butler. King Calak of Horuku doesn't like war either. If it weren't for Queen Carrie, we'd stop this operation right away. That Bellart was a man that shouldn't have been trusted to begin with. I agree then. Agree there, I mean. The more I think about it, the more I think Bellart is a very suspicious character. I knew that you couldn't be bad people the moment you set foot in this mansion. That soldier really isn't a good judge of character, is he? Yeah, I would think not. Hi. Sorry, guys. Most of the soldiers have been taken to the fortress. I wonder what Bellart is thinking. Maybe he's a really, really bad guy. I think that's likely. Good work. Please come on through. So the maid of honor moved. She's not no longer over here. Oh, it's just another one. Bellart is telling these lies to bring doubts into the king's mind. The king is a good man, but if he hears all these rumors, he naturally gets worried. Naturally. What about this guy over here? I didn't think you were really messages from Ambush. Philly says, didn't you make a promise? Oh yeah, is he gonna, like, do somersaults and twirl around or something? Chris says, you said something about doing a handstand and spinning around 3 times? Jurio says, you promised, remember? Okay, okay. Can you back up a bit? Awesome. And you would never find us if you didn't go back and talk to him. Jurio says, you said you were going to spin around 3 times. Please, forgive me. No one can do a handstand while wearing armor. Well, you were. You did. Is that enough? No. I need more. Is this the way we go? King Calak has ordered us to allow you to pass. We're all counting on you. Alright. We'll fight that thing next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.